Nassim Nicholas Taleb is a Lebanese-American essayist, scholar, statistician, and risk analyst, whose work focuses on problems of randomness, probability, and uncertainty. His 2007 book The Black Swan was described in a review by the Sunday Times as one of the 12 most influential books since World War II. Taleb is a best-selling author, has been a professor at several universities, serving as Distinguished Professor of Risk Engineering at the New York University Polytechnic School of Engineering since September 2008, and as co-editor-in-chief of the academic journal Risk and Decision Analysis since September 2014. He has also been a practitioner of mathematical finance, a hedge fund manager, a derivatives trader, and is currently a scientific advisor at Universal Investments. He criticized the risk management methods used by the finance industry and warned about financial crises, subsequently profiting from the late 2000s financial crisis. He advocates what he calls a black swan robust society, meaning a society that can withstand difficult to predict events. He proposes anti-fragility in systems, that is, an ability to benefit and grow from a certain class of random events, errors, and volatility, as well as convex tinkering, as a method of scientific discovery, by which he means that decentralized experimentation outperforms directed research. Early life and family background. Taleb was born in Amiraun, Lebanon, to Minerva Ghosn and Najib Taleb, a physician, oncologist, and a researcher in anthropology. His parents were Greek Orthodox Lebanese with French citizenship, and he attended a French school there, the Grand Lycée Franco-Libanais. His family saw its political prominence and wealth reduced by the Lebanese Civil War, which began in 1975. During the war, Taleb studied for several years in the basement of his family's home. Both sides of his family were prominent in the Lebanese Greek Orthodox Christian community. On his mother's side, his grandfather, Foir Nicholas Ghosn, and his great-grandfather, Nicholas Ghosn, were both deputy prime ministers. His paternal grandfather was a Supreme Court judge. His great-great-great-great-grandfather, Ibrahim Taleb, was a governor of the Ottoman semi-autonomous Mount Lebanon Governorate in 1861. Taleb has described himself as Greek Orthodox Christian. The Taleb family palazzo, built in 1860 by Florentine architects for his great-great-great-great-grandfather, still stands in Amiraun. Education. Taleb received his Bachelor and Master of Science degrees from the University of Paris. He holds an MBA from the Wharton School at the University of Pennsylvania, and a PhD in Management Science from the University of Paris. Under the direction of Eliot Gemmon, with Nicole El Karoui, Dilip Maiden, Patrice Ponce, and Marco Avellaneda as committee members. His dissertation focused on the mathematics of derivatives pricing. A polyglot, Taleb has a literary fluency in English, French, and classical Arabic, a conversational fluency in Italian and Spanish, and can read classical texts in Greek, Latin, Aramaic, and ancient Hebrew, as well as in the Canaanite script. Career. Finance career. Taleb has been a practitioner of mathematical finance, subscription, a hedge fund manager, a derivatives trader, and is currently a scientific advisor at Universal Investments. In 2011, he worked on a paper with the International Monetary Fund. Taleb considers himself less a businessman than an epistemologist of randomness, and says that he used trading to attain independence and freedom from authority. Taleb was a pioneer of tail risk hedging, which is intended to mitigate investors' exposure to extreme market moves. His business model has been to safeguard investors against crises while reaping rewards from rare events, and thus his investment management career has included several jackpots followed by lengthy dry spells. He has also held the following positions: Managing Director and Proprietary Trader at Credit Suisse Subs Worldwide, Chief Proprietary Arbitrage Derivatives Trader for Currencies, commodities and non-dollar fixed income at First Boston, chief currency derivatives trader for Bankinter Suez, managing director and worldwide head of financial option arbitrage at CIBC Wood Gundy, derivatives arbitrage trader at Bankers Trust, proprietary trader at BNP Paribas, independent option market maker on the Chicago Mercantile Exchange and founder of Empirica Capital. In a Wall Street Journal 2007 article, Taleb claimed he retired from trading in 2004, became a full-time author. Since 2007, Taleb has been a principal, senior scientific advisor at Universal Investments in Santa Monica, California, a tail protection firm owned and managed by former Empirica partner Mark Spitznagel. However, Taleb describes the nature of his involvement as totally passive from 2010 on. Taleb reportedly became financially independent after the crash of 1987 and was successful during the Nasdaq dive in 2000 as well as the financial crisis that began in 2007, a development which he attributed to the mismatch between statistical distributions used in finance and reality. Universa is a fund which is based on the Black Swan idea and to which Taleb is a principal advisor. Some of the separate funds managed by Universa made returns of 65% to 115% in October 2008. Following the economic crisis that started in 2008, Taleb has become an activist for what he called a Black Swan Robust Society, and as of July 2011, Taleb was writing a paper with the International Monetary Fund on identifying and mitigating tail risks in financial markets. Academic career. Taleb changed careers and became a mathematical researcher, scholar and philosophical essayist in 2006, and has held positions at NYU's Courant Institute of Mathematical Sciences, at University of Massachusetts Amherst, at London Business School, and at Oxford University. He has been Distinguished Professor of Risk Engineering at New York University Polytechnic School of Engineering. Since 2008, he was Distinguished Research Scholar at the said business school BT Center, University of Oxford. Taleb is co-editor-in-chief of the academic journal Risk and Decision Analysis, jointly teaches regular courses with Paul Wilmot in London, and occasionally participates in teaching courses toward the Certificate in Quantitative Finance. He is also co-faculty at the New England Complex Systems Institute. Writing career. Taleb's four-volume philosophical essay on uncertainty, titled The Incerto, covers the following books: Antifragile, The Black Swan, Fooled by Randomness and The Bed of Procrustes. Taleb's first non-technical book, Fooled by Randomness, about the underestimation of the role of randomness in life. Around the same time as the September 11th attacks, was selected by Fortune as one of the smartest 75 books known. His second non-technical book, The Black Swan, about unpredictable events, was published in 2007, selling close to 3 million copies. It spent 36 weeks on the New York Times bestseller list, 17 as hardcover and 19 weeks as paperback, and was translated into 31 languages. The Black Swan has been credited with predicting the banking and economic crisis of 2008. In 2007, in The Black Swan, Taleb warned about the coming crisis. Globalization creates interlocking fragility, while reducing volatility and giving the appearance of stability. In other words, it creates devastating black swans. We have never lived before under the threat of a global collapse. Financial institutions have been merging into a smaller number of very large banks. Almost all banks are now interrelated. So the financial ecology is swelling into gigantic, incestuous, bureaucratic banks. When one falls, they all fall. The increased concentration among banks seems to have the effect of making financial crises less likely. But when they happen, they are more global in scale and hit us very hard. We have moved from a diversified ecology of small banks with varied lending policies to a more homogeneous framework of firms that all resemble one another. True, we now have fewer failures, but when they occur, I shiver at the thought. The government-sponsored institution Fannie Mae, when I look at their risks, seems to be sitting on a barrel of dynamite, vulnerable to the slightest hiccup. But not to worry. Their large staff of scientists deemed these events unlikely. He warned of pseudo-stability in Syria. Dictatorships that do not appear volatile, like, say, Syria or Saudi Arabia, face a larger risk of chaos than, say, Italy, as the latter has been in a state of continual political turmoil since the Second War. A book of aphorisms, The Bed of Procrustes, Philosophical and Practical Aphorisms, was released in December 2010. The final book of his Incerto series, Antifragile, Things That Gain from Disorder, was published in November 2012 by Random House in the United States and Penguin in the United Kingdom. In the introduction of the book, Taleb describes it as follows. Some things benefit from shocks, they thrive and grow when exposed to volatility, randomness, disorder, and stressor and love adventure, risk, and uncertainty. Yet, in spite of the ubiquity of the phenomenon, there is no word for the exact opposite of fragile. Let us call it anti-fragile. Anti-fragility is beyond resilience or robustness. The resilient resists shocks and stays the same. The antifragile gets better. Taleb's non-technical writing style has been described as mixing the narrative, often semi-autobiographical style, with short philosophical tales and historical and scientific commentary. The sales of Taleb's first two books garnered an advance of $4 million for a follow-up book on anti-fragility. In summer 2013, Taleb stated that his intention was to complete a multi-volume mathematical expression of the ideas of the more philosophical works, with rigorous derivations and proofs. Volume 1 is complete, Philosophical Influences and Ideas. Influences. Taleb's acknowledged influences for his philosophical and intellectual positions include Friedrich Hayek, Karl Popper, Henri Poincaré, Michel de Montaigne, Benoit Mandelbrot, Frédéric Bastiat, Seneca the Younger, and Francis Bacon. The following ideas have been acknowledged to have influenced Daniel Kahneman. Ideas and Theories. Taleb's book The Bed of Procrustes summarizes the central problem. We humans, facing limits of knowledge, and things we do not observe, the unseen and the unknown, resolve the tension by squeezing life and the world into crisp commoditized ideas. Taleb disagrees with Platonic approaches to reality to the extent that they lead people to have the wrong map of reality rather than no map at all. He opposes most economic and grand social science theorizing, which in his view suffer acutely from the problem of overuse of Plato's theory of forms. Based on these and other constructions, he advocates for what he calls a black swan robust society, meaning a society that can withstand difficult to predict events. He has also proposed that biological, economic, and other systems exhibit an ability to benefit and grow from volatility, including particular type of random errors and events, a characteristic of these systems that he terms antifragility. Relatedly, he also believes that universities are better at public relations and claiming credit than generating knowledge. He argues that knowledge and technology are usually generated by what he calls stochastic tinkering, rather than by top-down directed research, and has proposed option like experimentation as a way to outperform directed research as a method of scientific discovery, an approach he terms convex tinkering. Taleb has called for cancellation of the Nobel Memorial Prize in Economics, saying that the damage from economic theories can be devastating. He opposes top-down knowledge as an academic illusion and believes that price formation obeys an organic process. Together with Espengarda Hoare, Taleb asserts that option pricing is determined in a heuristic way by operators, not by a model, and that models are lecturing birds on how to fly. Pablo Triana has explored this topic with reference to Hoare and Taleb. and says that perhaps Taleb is correct to urge that banks be treated as utilities forbidden to take potentially lethal risks, while hedge funds and other unregulated entities should be able to do what they want. Taleb's writings discuss the error of comparing real-world randomness with the structured randomness in quantum physics, where probabilities are remarkably computable, and games of chance like casinos, where probabilities are artificially built. Taleb calls this the Ludwig fallacy. His argument centers on the idea that predictive models are based on Plato's theory of forms, gravitating towards mathematical purity and failing to take some key ideas into account, such as the impossibility of possessing all relevant information, that small unknown variations in the data can have a huge impact, and flawed theories, models that are based on empirical data and that fail to consider events that have not taken place but could have taken place. Discussing the Ludwig fallacy in The Black Swan, he writes, "The dark side of the moon is harder to see. Beaming light on it costs energy. In the same way, beaming light on the unseen is costly in both computational and mental effort." In the second edition of The Black Swan, he posited that the foundations of quantitative economics are faulty and highly self-referential. He states that statistics is fundamentally incomplete as a field, as it cannot predict the risk of rare events, a problem that is acute in proportion to the rarity of these events. With the mathematician Raphael Douady, he called the problem statistical undecidability. Taleb sees his main challenge as mapping his ideas of robustification and antifragility, that is, how to live and act in a world we do not understand, and build robustness to black swan events. Taleb introduced the idea of the fourth quadrant in the exposure domain. One of its applications is in his definition of the most effective risk management approach, what he calls the barbell strategy, which is based on avoiding the middle in favor of linear combination of extremes across all domains, from politics to economics to one's personal life. These are deemed by Taleb to be more robust to estimation errors. For instance, he suggests that investing money in medium-risk investments is pointless because risk is difficult, if not impossible, to compute. His preferred strategy is to be both hyper-conservative and hyper-aggressive at the same time. For example, an investor might put 80 to 90% of their money in extremely safe instruments, such as treasury bills, with the remainder going into highly risky and diversified speculative bets. An alternative suggestion is to engage in highly speculative bets with a limited downside. Taleb asserts that by adopting these strategies, a portfolio can be robust, that is, gain a positive exposure to black swan events while limiting losses suffered by such random events. Together with Donald Gemman and Elliot Gemman, he modeled the maximum entropy barbell, which consists in to constrain only what can be constrained and to maximize entropy elsewhere, based on an insight by E.T. Jaynes that economic life increases in entropy under regulatory and other constraints. Taleb also applies a similar barbell-style approach to health and exercise. Instead of doing steady and moderate exercise daily, he suggests that it is better to do a low-effort exercise such as walking slowly most of the time, while occasionally expending extreme effort. He avers that the human body evolved to live in a random environment, with various unexpected but intense efforts and much rest.